Chris. A-Hole Productions.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that's fucking intense. Well, cool. Now Joe after work and maybe Barry can get a different experience here. Well, Mia would be dead right now. Yeah. Oh, shit. We're Mia. No way. Flashback to the boat crash. Look at this fucking thing. This looks amazing. You better start running. Rare achievement unlocked. Escape from the Baker family home. Holy shit. Redo. Wait, what? Yeah, no, we're not dead. Let's see if there's anything out here we can pick up. Shit. RE7 is so fucked up. I know, man. This is a crazy game. Fuck, what is... Is this present day, or... Or is this, like, right after the crash? I'm excited. Oh, fuck. Nope, this must be fresh. Ethan? Oh, it... Fuck! Ethan! What? The death count is up to date. Yep, we're good, DC. We're good, Deadeye. We're caught up. Thank you for asking. Holy shit. Ethan just got fucking sucked away. We almost saw him. That's crazy. And they hit his face. That's interesting. All right. I don't like how Evelyn keeps calling us mommy. And then Jack earlier was like, I'm the daddy. I'm the daddy here. He's not going to be the new daddy. Like, just crazy shit happening. So is that some kind of virus? Yeah, it's, I don't know yet. Actually, I don't know yet. They mentioned, Marguerite. I read a file where she went to get her head scanned at a doctor. She got an x-ray and the doctor found some kind of fungus in her head. And it seems to be the fungus is kind of checking them. So, oh, Joe says, yeah, I'm confused now. How does this work? You picked Zoe. Yeah, I figured this. We'll talk afterwards about how different it is. I don't want to get too crazy in the chat because I don't want any spoilers to accidentally drop or anything. Shit. I have it, but I'm banned from it for kicking ass too much. Shit. She has something. Strange bottle that you found in your pocket after waking up at the Baker estate. It's probably important. Let's look at it. E-001. Hey, E-001, that's the picture at the beginning, right? That we saw with the grandma? It showed a picture of the grandma and it said E-001 written on the back. Crazy. So what the fuck is in that vial then? Is the grandma in that vial? All right, good peeps. I'm going to take a nap before edits. I'll catch you later. Have a good night. Oh, man. Yes, you too, Joe. Love y'all. Love you too, man. Love you too, Joe. Have a good night. Holy shit. Speaking of, Joe, if you want something fun in the background while you're editing later, hit Command Resident Evil. And you guys in the chat, feel free to bookmark that link and check it out later. I worked really hard on it last night. I couldn't sleep. I had a doctor appointment today. I had to get a CT scan, or yesterday, I should say. We're not going to talk about it until after we play Resident Evil in like a couple days. So forgive me for not talking. I know John Lee earlier and some people wanted to discuss it, but I'm not ready yet to talk about anything. So we're just here. I don't want anything to ruin Resident Evil Day for us. Fucking A, this is creepy. But hit, yeah, Resident Evil, bam, Joe, I have to work on it. So take that. That is something I worked really hard on. I basically edited my first two Twitch streams on here, which were recorded around the time I met Joe in San Francisco when we got flown up by Capcom to play the Lantern demo and stuff. So my first two Twitch streams, I played the Jill Valentine campaign and the Chris Redfield campaign of the Resident Evil 1 remake. And I edited them together like a movie. So it cuts between Chris and Jill the entire time with a commentary track over all of it that out kind of talks about the entire Resident Evil universe from the George Romero movie to the Paul Anderson movies to everything, the comics, the video games. It's basically my history of Resident Evil, kind of all jumbled and all over the place. But I think you guys will really like it. I worked really, really, really fucking hard on it. So hopefully you like it. But I always get nervous before I go to see a doctor. And I just was like, well, I can work on my Batman thing where I actually have to sit and film, or I could just sit and edit something that I've wanted to edit for a while. And I just spent 8 hours editing that. I was up till like 6 a.m. last night. Holy shit, man. This place is... Oh, excuse me. Oh. Let's make sure there's nothing else in here before we go that way.
They're dead. They're all dead. The engine room. What the fuck are you talking about? She killed them all. Fuck. What the hell is going on? We need some weapons. Is there any weapons on this ship? I don't know. Let's go this way. Maybe we can get out of here.
Whoa, I was trying to look on them to see if they had any kind of like logos, but it didn't look like it. So what does the dirty coin from the demo do? It seems to just have been an extra coin, like an extra whatchamacallit coin, ancient coin or whatever they're called. So we actually used it. It only counts as one coin. I thought maybe it would count as like two or three coins, but it's basically just an extra coin. And what it did was we put it towards the gun. So the first thing we bought was the gun in the bird cages. We had like 9 coins right when we came across the bird cages. Well, we had 8, and then we found one out near the trailer. So then I was like, all right, let's everyone in the chat was like, buy the pistol. So we did, and we're saving it. It's in our inventory. So hopefully it's strong and we'll use it later. Hopefully we'll get the chance to use it. Shit. And then the second thing we bought was the steroids, and we've used 3. We found 2 steroids and used 1. Oh, look at that antique coin. Shit. So yeah, there's only 1 birdcage left, and there's 5 coins we need for it, but we only have 2. So I think I missed a bunch of shit, because I'm assuming we're nearing the end of the game now. That would be my guess, but I don't know if that's true or not. Oh shit. What is it about Resident Evil and boats, man? I think like Resident Evil Gaiden took place on a boat. Resident Evil Dead Aim took place on a boat. I think part of, no, I think it was just Dead Aim. Yeah. I was going to say Survivor, but no, Survivor didn't have a boat. Capcom just loves going on boats. I'm on a boat, motherfucker. Oh, so it's really for buying. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. There's 3 bird cages. And one of them has a stability thing, which basically makes you load your gun faster and makes you like aim better, or your hands are steady during recoils. We used one of those, but like I said, I was hoping to buy the second one. Yeah, don't tough that shitty ground, dude. Yeah, I know, right? So I was hoping to gain 3 more, but I don't think we're gonna before the end. I think we missed too much stuff. Crew register. Captain Ed Carlisle. Paul Fitzgerald was the chief engineer. First officer, Giovanni Finetti. Second officer, Clark Walsh. Mechanic, Dwayne Chalmers. Communication technician, Jim Stockman. And physician, Gerald Waddell. Okay. She's not my child. Okay, that's creepy as fuck. Wait. Oh, it's just you. Just you again. And I think we... Whoa. Whoa. He's like petrified. Yeah, oh, shit. Okay. So, yeah, I know I was questioning it earlier, but clearly this is present day. This is after Ethan and Zoe took off on the boat, and I guess Mia came to the wreckage. She's inside me. She's inside everyone. Shit. Look at this, man. Don't touch. Don't touch. Excuse me. I'm sorry for yawning. I just, I've been up a while. I'm waiting for the sun to come out, but I keep thinking it's gonna. Because I want to take my dog out for a walk. Ooh, shit. There's that angel. That's weird that painting is here when it was inside the Baker home, too. All right. Wait. Tanker Annabelle, built 1987, deadweight tonnage 70. Oh, deadweight tonnage. The deadweight of this thing is 71,000 tons, and its length is 948 feet. The sun is out here. Keep playing until dawn. Yeah, we're gonna go. I think we're close enough. I think I have a feeling we're nearing the end, and if that's the case, then we're just gonna keep going. Whoa, whoa. Hey, her boots, she's wearing the boots.
Are you remembering?
What?
What?
Are you?
What the fuck? Oh, shit. Like crawling around for some reason. I don't know. When I get afraid, I always crouch. My character always crouches. Damn. Damn. Looks like we're going for a swim. Inspect, inspect, inspect. I think we missed two files. Let me check. Files. Oh, we have no files. Okay. I think with Ethan, we are missing two files. So I'm hoping we can get a chance to go back to the house so I could look for them. Who is she? The wheelchair one. Oh, the old lady? I don't know yet. No one's really addressed her by name. Although I'm starting to have my suspicions. Oh, my dog's up. Whoa.
Wait!
I said what now?
Please.
Whoa. I can't use that here. Okay. Oh, fuck. There are monsters? I have no weapons. right, we got an herb there. Did it see me? No. Nope. It's gonna see me now. Nope, still didn't see me. What? It's like it's saying like grab something here, but there's nothing there. Is Ethan dead? I don't know. Be right back, gonna take my last bag out. No problem, kitty. That one is creepy as fuck. Yeah, this the crawlers, the grasshoppers as I call them. So this is, I was going to say, there's got to be a room that like is adjacent to them. So that way we could like get around them. Chem fluid. Okay. We're going to need this, aren't we? Yep. Oh, machine gun ammo. Holy shit. Looks like we are going to get a gun. Not right now, though. Shit. Hello. Fuck, we got him with the save room. Didn't know this was going to be a save room. That worked out really nicely. Handgun. Oh, shit. Oh, look at that little thing. yeah, I don't know. It looked like Ethan got taken away. That's all I know. So I don't know what's going on, dude. Yeah, I try to refrain from asking too many questions that I might not know the answers to, because I don't want to invite someone who does know the answers to come in and spoil the game for us, Tony. So just be cautious about that. First floor. It's too late for us, but at least I can let the world know what happened here. I was on night shift yesterday, so I was taking a nap in the bunk room around noon. I was half asleep and I heard a little girl laughing. Or was that all in my head? I woke up at 19:30. There was some sort of ruckus in the passageway. Drew, one of the engineers, came in and said there was something going on down below, maybe a riot. He looked pale in the face. He told me he was going down to check it out, but he never came back. It must have been around 1950 when I heard the scream. I went to the laundry room to check and saw Clark being eaten by some sort of blackish monster. The monster turned and started coming toward me, huge shark-like teeth snapping in its jaws. I just screamed like a little girl and ran for it. Now I'm huddled in the bunk room, shaking as I write this. There's a whole host of those creatures lurking in the passageway now. I can still hear screams now and then, but there's no way I'm going out there now. And that's it. I've written everything I know. Giovanni Finetti. Cool, she gets a Makarov. Oh, yeah? Nice. Unfortunately, I don't have a knife. So I'm going to have to shoot that fucking crate. So you're just going to finish it all at once? Yeah, I'm going to try, Tony. I'm going to try at least. I don't know. I'm getting tired. And usually I'm not, it's hard to like keep focused. And some of the puzzles, like I know we took a while to do one of the things earlier and I could tell like I'm starting to fade. So we're going to do what we can though. All right, nothing there, I guess. Sometimes you can turn an item and weird shit happens to it. Like, we turned a teddy bear earlier and it leaked ooze out of it. It was pretty gross looking. Whoa. Handgun ammo. Yay. All right. Sweet. Maybe now I will shoot that crate. Because it's got first aid in it. Nice. All right, that was worth a bullet. I'd say that's worth a bullet. Oh, hello. Nothing inside. Oh, here we go. Document. Dear Janet, hey, how's it going? I guess half a year or so will have passed by the time you get this letter. Life is so boring here, day after day, just the same old sea. Although there is one thing that's different. This time we have some passengers sailing with us, which hardly ever happens. It's a couple with a little girl. I think that's a couple with a little girl. I think they're distant relatives of the captain. Imagine traveling on a tanker instead of a passenger ship. They must be hard up. I tried talking to the little girl earlier, and her dad shot me this nasty look. What's he so worried about? Now that I think about it, the captain said he didn't even have any relatives. Maybe I'm overthinking this. I miss you. Love, Jim. Then you will need some well rest. Yeah, I know for sure, man. If we finish this, yeah, I'm definitely going to be sleeping for a good chunk of the day after this. Hunting life. Guns for the avid hunter. All right. Shit. Ow. Gonna come in here, big boy? I guess you are. Those things open doors? I don't think so. Wait, seek uptime. What's up? Oh yeah, 3 hours, huh? I said we would stop around 3 hours. Oh, we're back in this room. Okay. First floor, second floor, third floor. Yeah, so in about 30 minutes, guys, I may stop the stream and then just start right back up. If I'm too tired to continue, I'll let you know. But I'm trying to keep the video short so that way it's easier for me to download them and edit them later for YouTube. Thank you for the reminder, Kitty. So in about 20, 30 minutes, I'm going to do that. I'm going to let my dog out and then we'll come back on. I mean, literally, I'll be offline for like 3 minutes. It'll be really quick. All right, second floor. Locked from the other side. Oh, that makes it easy. Makes it easy on where to go from here. Can we take that pipe? I'd like to have like a melee weapon. Shit. Well. Fuck me. Here we go. Here we go. Fuck. Whoa. Yeah, I'm kind of wondering why tapes are such a big deal. I'm wondering if there's some kind of significance or if it's just a thing designed for the game.
Watch it. What? Why? You need to remember so we can be a family.
Okay. Old videotape with guck on it. Awesome. So she's suppressing some kind of memory, huh? All right, here we go, guys. Old videotape. Mia Winter's cabin, test subject E001, see transport log, top secret. Okay. I'm hiding in my bed right now, so I'm fucking cold outside. It's, oh man, Tony, sorry, dude. Stay warm, brother. Achievement unlocked. Be kind, please rewind. Watch all the videotapes in a single playthrough. Oh. I can't imagine that's too hard to do. This one, it's they force you to watch it. The sewer gators one, I guess, is the one that probably people will skip. Because they've seen it 1,000 times. But the other, there's only 4 tapes.
You're getting worse.
She must have infected me during the attack. And I'm too far gone anyway.
Alan. He has a watch too.
It's my fault she got out.
Yeah, it is your fault. But that doesn't mean I'm gonna let you die.
I just had another nightmare. I didn't even know I'd fall asleep. Oh, Deadeye. Too bad we don't get snow in town. That's true.
I can't believe this is happening.
Here. Take it. It has her tissue samples. You find her. You fix this.
Oh shit, I'm like in control. Oh shit, I'm like, oh, what the fuck? Thank you, Tony. Thank you, bud. So what's going on with this guy? Like, and they seem to be kind of close. Whoa. When did I get the machine gun? Holy shit. Oh, this is a flashback. That's why. So I guess, yeah, this is the tape we're watching. So, machine gun ammo. So I guess we're going to find where I leave it, maybe. And then go find it there. Special Operations Division. The SOD. Director Alan Droney and caretaker Mia Winters. Recent reports suggest that if Evelyn remains at her current location, she's at high risk of being stolen by opposing organizations. Your orders, therefore, are to transfer Evelyn to our Central American branch for safekeeping until further notice. During transfer, be sure to adhere to the following protocols. Act as parental guardians for Evelyn at all times to avoid suspicion. Manage Evelyn's vitals via the genome codex provided. All the mission is compromised beyond reconciliation. Dispose of Evelyn. Oh, if the mission is compromised, dispose of Evelyn. Holy shit. You didn't miss anything on the tape at all. It ended with this guy sitting here on the couch. So he's just chilling. So nobody missed anything when we hit that little hiccup there. So sorry about that. All right, so we're on a fresh boat. Shit, what floor are we on? No way. Dude, yeah, hopefully. Never touched or played with snow, huh? Locked from the other side. Wait, what? Climb up. Oh, shit. Whoa.
She's close.
Target acquired, 25. The number displayed shows the distance to the target. Okay. That's cool. No, you don't, Tony. Snow can suck. It can suck what? She just means it can suck in general. What are you? Supplements. Holy shit, we're straight up playing a flashback tape where we're like armored up and like we got weapons and supplements and everything. Shit, well, clearly we got to go that way. Let's eliminate some doors first. Yeah, let's just eliminate some doors first. Let's inspect everything before we get all crazy. Can't use that here. What is that? It makes everything colder, and when it melts, everything is all muddy. There you go. That's true. All right, so those look like Ghostbuster traps. Herb. Well, the fact that we're still playing and picking stuff up, I doubt any of this will be transferable to Ethan, but I'd like to find another coin. Since we already found one. Just another supplements. Yeah. And she's right, you have to shovel it too. It's a lot of hard work, Snow. It is pretty. It's very nice to look at. So we're on the second floor. Okay. All right. So she is in that room. And we just got to go do the climbing around thing. All right. So we check every door. Well, we don't need to climb up anymore. Because we got this shit. Man. All right. Here we go. Oh, shit. Is this her? Fucking A. Yeah, I'm gonna leave these doors wide open. She's vomiting. She's vomiting? That's not vomiting. That's their term for this?
Damn, I'll have to reset.
How's it going?
She's vomiting. Far more in excess of her body mass.
Oh, great. We're gonna be seeing a lot more of her ugly friends if this keeps up.
Damn. Find Evelyn. All right. Herb, I like that. Can't make anything yet, though. Shit, okay. So we'll take the elevator. I did kind of take the long way, but... Oof. I like this gun. Oh! Come on. Thing's dead? Like, I didn't see it explode. Guess we're going down. Oh, shit. Can I grab that? No? All right. Well, fine. I won't then. I gotta be careful. The submachine guns, easy to eat up the ammo. Shit. Ow. Get to New York, y'all hate it a bit. Yeah. The monster does have a little bit of Ouroboros, doesn't it? Kind of sluggy looking, black, tarry. Yeah, that's true. I imagine a lot of these viruses in these games now just kind of share, you know, strands at some, you know, to an extent. We got like three herbs, but no fucking, like, chem stuff to put to mix with them. Machine gun ammo. Oh, that's good. That I definitely need. How many herbs do I have? I have herbs, but I have no, yeah, I have no health items. Damn it. Damn it. It's gonna be a short game if we don't get our shit together. Oh shit, it's a tyrant one. Damn. Those ones scare me with those long, those tyrant arms. Shit. Getting further away from her. Oh, here we go. We're getting close again. Oh, thank goodness. No, nothing. What do we pick up? Evelyn tissue samples. I feel like we just picked up like a remote bomb. Shit. Really? That SMG's clip looks unique though. Yeah, it's cool looking. Yeah, I don't know. Different for sure. He's coming. All right. Let's save the last one for later. Cause I'm pretty sure we're gonna have to use it. I have a feeling there's gonna be like a horde of these things coming at us at some point. It's a magazine, sorry. Oh, yeah. Well, don't get too caught up on stuff like that. I know it's a nitpicky thing, and I know you admitted it was. Tony's first language is not English. Just keep that in mind. So he might not know all the different terms. I know you didn't know that confusion. I'm just letting you know, bub. All right, here we go. All right. Getting further away. That's a good thing. Come on, Cletus. Corrosive. Now, what does that do? Yeah, it's okay, dude. And the confusion didn't mean anything by it. I think confusion actually has a tremendous respect for the proper terminology. So, he didn't mean anything by it. I want them to bring the Operation Raccoon City back, the remake one. The remake of Operation Raccoon City? What? There's no remake of, right? They only just released it once on the Xbox 360. I think a strong acid that can dissolve certain metals. Oh, well, that's going to be coming in handy. Chem fluid, finally. Shit. It's like first thing I wanted to make was a herb. It's me. I have had it drilled into my brain. Ah, it's okay, dude. It's yeah, just so you're aware, because I remember Tony got that a little bit from a guy named Cromer, who is actually like super like spell checky, you know, like he just gets like super he gets like all spell checky, and it's like anytime you misspell anything, he gets all over you about it, and it's, I think it's also a compulsive thing with him, so I never really take offense to it, but I know some people could, and I know Tony's trying because it's English isn't his first language, but he speaks it well. He's great in the chat too, so sometimes it's easy to confuse that. It's like, oh, he's...
No, Evie,
so is that why she keeps calling us mommy? Because we're
what did you call me?
I don't want to live at the lab anymore. I want a house, and I want you to be my mommy.
Okay, Evie. I'll be your mommy. Just come back with me right now, okay?
She's in here somewhere. Shit. Where is she? Like on the ceiling? Shit.
Where are you, Evie?
She teleported. What the fuck? Damn, what is this little girl? Shit.
Evie, wait!
Did you find her?
Yes, but she ran off. She's making
this is a long tape.
Those things are everywhere.
Not like Happy Birthday, where we're just in one room and I couldn't figure out what to do. Like, this is a long tape. But what camera do we have hooked to us that would show this footage? Like, is she walking around with like a headset right now? And how is it transferred to VHS? I know that's like a really nitpicky thing to mention, but it's a question. What's up, Angel? Oh shit, okay. Let's did I get them both? Of course not. I went to work and got... But damn, dude, you're still going? Were you blowing some noses? Dude, you went to work and are back now? It should be a flash drive or something. Yeah, that's... I was thinking that, too. That's why I was wondering if it was a specifically... Like, there was going to be a story element to explain why it's tapes. You know what I'm saying? But I guess we haven't reached that point yet, so maybe we don't know, but... All right, so we got more bombs. Damn. Ah, look at that. Chem fluid. See, that's why you always look. We're just going to... I know we can make one of those psychotropic things to tell us where items are, but I don't want to mess with that shit. Oh, shit. Well, hopefully fire hurts the molded. Wow. I missed with, like, every one of those shots. That sucked. I missed with, like, 10 shots there. Oh, shit. At least I got the big one. And he only took a few bullets to go down. Phew. Oh, wait. The big one's still alive. Shit. Damn. Oh, my God. That's crazy. I'm just done some study real quick. No problem, Tony. Do your thing. Come on. That siren. Yeah, I know, right? That siren are for real. So she's going to floor one. S2? No, she didn't go to floor one. We're gonna go to floor three. I so want to take that fuse out so we can open those other doors, but oh, that's not what we need. Oh shit.
Emergency safety lockdown system has been engaged.
Great. Is that the Red Queen? Seek has been streaming for 3 hours. Not true. Well, yes. Technically, I have been. But we stopped stream after our first 4.5 hours, and then we stopped stream again after 3 hours. So now this is our third stream. Wow, we can see this what this place looks like before it gets all screwed up. Nice, remote bomb, sweet. Seek is in the zone. Yeah, I know, I'm gonna be missing a lot of the chat. It's because I'm tired. Shit. Yeah, it's just because I'm tired, so yeah, I may miss a little bit of the chat, so I apologize. Boom. All right, we got a shit ton of remote bombs. Locked from the other side, great. Damn, dude. Glad you're having fun. I'm totally having a good time, man, for sure. Thanks, Santa. Thank you for saying that. I am, dude. Definitely. Oh, shit. Can't go in there? Guess we're climbing through. I'm gonna watch you and sleep now. Oh, I will. Thank you, Kitty. Thank you for being here tonight. Thanks for being a mod on here, and thanks for cheering us all up, and congrats on winning the hoodie. I will let you know when I send it out. Give me about a week or two, and I'll try to get it out to you ASAP. Everyone, send Kitty some love. Have a good night, Kitty. All right, well, we definitely need to go to the third floor, but let's go check and see what's down here real quick. Nothing. You know, for a ship, there's not a lot going on, but I guess they also did say they had a skeleton crew, and they normally don't transport civilians, which is why they thought it was weird that they were transporting us, who we were posing as a family. So it's kind of like, almost like Alice and the dude from the first movie, Spence. They were like posing to be a husband and wife, but they were really umbrella operatives that were guarding the hive. So that's kind of interesting. Smooth move. Kitty, love. Where are we now? We're still in the boat, and it is that fucking noise. Oh, this is where we're watching the tape in the present. All right, we're getting closer. All right, so we gotta go that way. Any items over here? No? Nobody? Bueller? So umbrellas in this? I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I'm just taking a guess here on what the yeah. And just so you guys know, careful with the questions, because I know some people in the chat do know the answers, and I'm just trying, I don't want to start a discussion and accidentally get spoiled. But I don't know if umbrellas in this. I just was saying, like, it reminded me of the movie where Umbrella kind of had that role. Do that, kitten. You'll stay on? Okay, no problem. You'll stay on chat. Tablet dies, but oh, okay. No problem.
How did you get here?
No clue now, anyway. Yeah.
She's out of control. Without the treatment, she's deteriorating.
Without the treatment?
That's a good thing we're already dying.
Don't say that.
Damn, dude.
She trusts you. That little bitch, she never trusts. Okay, wait.
Whoa, whoa.
Evie, no, Evie, Evie.
Alan, listen.
I didn't mean to call you that.
She's
Evie,
trying to take control. You have to fight her.
Oh. Oh.
Evelyn, stop. Stop right now.
Don't touch me, don't.
Oh, it's... He's the dude from the trailer. Or that screenshot. Oh, my God. No problem. No problem, dude. I appreciate it. Oh, shit. End of tape? Damn. That was intense. I haven't seen... We haven't found... Lucas yet. Jack, I think we finally killed for real. And Marguerite, I think we killed. So I think we're just down to just Lucas at some point, but yeah, that was crazy, dude. Anything in there? No, nothing. There's his life preserve jackets. So this is not actually happening, right? Yeah, this is a tape. We're watching a tape right now. Yeah, I think we probably started it right before you came in. But yes, we're watching a tape right now. Apparently the final tape in the game, so I imagine we're getting pretty... Wait. Wait, what?
Ethan. You were right.
Sorry about the lip sync, but I don't know what's going on with the video game. The words don't match up with the lips. They haven't pretty much the whole game.
Stay away. Forget that you ever knew me.
Okay, so that's at the beginning. Okay, so that's at the beginning of the game. That's the message. But she sent that 3 years ago, because this apparently is when she goes missing, 3 years prior. Oh shit! Oh damn! Oh shit!
We'll be together.
Whoa. Oh, no way. Whoa. Oh, shit. Where's Barry was right. What the fuck is that? So that was Mia that fell off. I thought that was Ethan's hands. Whoa. Yeah, no DeLoreans for us, Santa. Yeah, that infection mold or whatever is alive. It seems to be being controlled by that little girl, but yeah. Holy shit. This is fucking intense. All right, it's probably going to take a minute to load. Damn. This fucking game, dude. Shit. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna have fun editing these for YouTube. Man. All of you guys, thank you for being here today. I know some of you have stuck with me all night. I really, really appreciate that. Even though we had a couple stops and starts along the way, I appreciate you all being here. And, I'm just glad we made it this far, man. I don't know if I'll be able to stay awake long enough for us to beat it, but this is pretty awesome. Like I said, we did a 4.5-hour stream and a 3-hour stream. So we should be around, and then we just probably been playing for like an hour now. So we should be around the 8.5-9 hour marker for this game. So that's pretty good. That's a pretty good length for a first time through a Resident Evil game. And I think we're near the end, but I don't know how close. So, and we still have to deal with Lucas. I think he's still out there. We had to fight Jack a second time. He came back as like a big monster, which was crazy. I didn't even know it was him at first. I thought we straight up killed Jack, but yeah, he came back. Yeah, crazy. People have been here all day. I know, man. It's crazy. Yeah, 8 to 9 hours so far.
Now do you remember?
Yes, Evelyn. I remember.
Can we be a family like before?
No, Evie. We can't be a family. We were never a family. We will never be a family.
Then I don't need you anymore.
Fuck? Oh, there's a save here? That's nice. That's nice of the game to do that. Let's check our time. Maybe that girl is the one that Barry brings out. Oh, yeah, from Revelations 2. It doesn't look like it. Evie? No, she's going by a different name then. So we've been 8.5 hours on normal mode. And I'm actually pretty impressed with myself that we played on normal instead of easy. And I'm glad we made it this far. All right, we got 9 bullets. Shit. Gotta love that. Yeah, they OP you a little bit in the old ones. Oh, this is the contents have been taken. E-neck toxin. Does something, any subject is, oh wow, everything's crossed out. Shit. We gotta go that way? Or do we go this way? Alright, let's go into this room real quick. I think it's a dead end, so let's just go check and see what's in here. Oh no, there's another door. Shit. Yeah, it might. That's a good thought. Oh, there's the laptop we recorded on. Apparently 3 years ago. Have we really been missing 3 years? Wow, we need this machine gun right now. Oh, thank goodness. So we have 3 of those now. Okay, cool. Shit. We don't have any of that. I'm a fan of continuity, if there is any. You know what? Actually, Santa, there's been some really interesting ones. Yeah, the little girl with Barry is different. Yeah, because she has Alex Wesker's memories. Yeah, so that's a little bit of a different thing. Damn, we need like all kind of keys. It looks like we're going to be here a while. So earlier, we found out that Lucas Baker, who is still out there, we didn't really catch him and kill him yet. Lucas apparently was like a really smart kid. A lot of these things around the house, like the crank, you know, like raising and lowering the bridges and stuff, some of the puzzles, Lucas actually designed and created, which I thought was really cool. But there actually is a connection to George Trevor from the original Resident Evil, because it says Lucas couldn't figure out the shadow puzzles and how to make those work. So he had to hire him and Jack Baker had to hire an outside contractor, and the outside contractor was called Trevor and Chamberlain Constructions. I was like, that's pretty cool. And then also we found a newspaper article written by Alyssa Ashcroft. She's the news reporter from Resident Evil Outbreak. So that was pretty cool too. And I think someone said there's a book around here somewhere written by O'Brien, who's from Revelations 1, but I haven't found that. Oh shit. Just notice your shirt. Nice. Yeah, I have 4 Resident Evil shirts, and I was trying to decide which ones to wear. So if, when I played the demo, I wore one.
Maybe it still works.
And, when I played the demo, I wore a different one, the one I won at Comic-Con, and then this one I got during the road tour in San Francisco.
Ethan.
Ethan.
I hope I make it in time. Okay. Bottom level.
Shit. Shit. Oh. Oh, shit.
Stop it, Evelyn!
Wow.
Fucking hallucinations. Where is she?
Hallucinations. Oh, that's... Man. That's cool. Said Laura Crafty. Like, I hate that they give you so many options on where to go, because it's like... It's like, what if I go the wrong way, or what if I miss something, or... Oh, shit. Gunpowder. Nothing. Nothing. Whew. Whoa, look at this. So this is the boat? Or did we crash into something? This is the boat, huh? Yeah, this is not a commercial freighter. And like I said, I think they said they were running it on a skeleton crew. Yeah, that's interesting. Damn. Whoa. Homeboy got frozen trying to jump out the window. Nothing? Fuck you, game. Yo, yeah, we've been outside. Well, we were at the captain's cabin. We were at the Baker farm for the most of the, you know, first half of the game. Shit, we need a key. Damn it. Lug wrench, okay. Ship map, that's good. So we were on the Baker farm, and I think it took us about 2 hours or so, 2.5 hours, but we eventually got outside and then walked around their farm. And then we just left their farm a little bit ago, their house and everything, and we ended up on this boat. But Ethan, we had to make a choice whether we were going to save Zoe or Mia here, our wife. And I chose Zoe, and I had some pretty good reasons for it, which, you know, I won't explain too much right now. But then also I figured most people who played it probably chose Mia. So I thought, well, let's get a different experience than other people. And then because we chose Mia, Zoe and Ethan went missing. They got hit with Evelyn. Like, she came and got them and wrapped up Ethan and brought him down to the basement, it looks like. So we got to go down and get him. Game feels cramped. Yeah, I know. Like, this, especially this level, like this area especially, feels really cramped. Remote bomb, sweet. I was kind of hoping we would get one of those. Damn. Yeah. Yeah, we were outside, but the Baker house felt pretty tight, like cramped, and this place feels really cramped. Yeah, it's a nice, scary setting. Fucking boats, man. All right, well, let's get it on. Here we go. By the way, 8 people today. Thank you for being in here. Shit. Bam. Lug nut. Fixed it. It really did show its Resident Evil style, with it being almost supernatural in the beginning. Then the medical side, the experiments come up, and it reminds... It does. It actually does. Like, I would... I could definitely see someone not agreeing with that. But, shit. But I think it does. Yeah, I think you're right. Lewis, the cable is completely fried. We had a replacement, but we had to use it to fix something in the third floor sick bay. You're going to have to go ask Dr. Waddell for it. I'm needed down in number 2 engine room, but I can't get down there unless we get this thing working. From Dwayne. I'd love if Chris would break through a concrete wall, smirked, and just says, "Kept you waiting, huh?" Or threw a boulder at you. Oh my God, a knife. Yes. Yes. Oh, and yeah, we got the remote bombs too. Oh, excuse me. We don't have that acid stuff yet. Holy shit, the sun's up. Oh, shit. Shit, that only blew his arm off? Oh, thank God. Oh, thank goodness. Shit. Knife to meet you. Knife to meet you. I did too, but you know, the sad thing with umbrellas, they never really did anything with it. Like after, you know, up to Code Veronica, like 4, just like Umbrella's gone in the opening credits of 4. They're like Leon is narrating and he's like, "Yeah, Umbrella had stock market drop." I'm like, "Stock market? Dude, they fucking annihilated, like, they annihilated an entire city. And then they also infested an island, Sheena Island, which was pretty well populated." It blew my mind that they were just like, "Oh, they swept Umbrella under the rug." And then they tried to do the Neo Umbrella thing because they're like, "Yep, we fucked up. We should have made 4 about Umbrella." And it's like, I mean, I'm all for you guys trying something different, but Umbrella's kind of the bad guy in this universe. You know, so I'm not saying they can't have other bad guys, but so like this game in particular, I like the bad guys in this one. If they turn out to not have Umbrella ties, that's totally fine with me. By the way, I wonder what the fuck was that potion all about? It can even cure the cut. I know. I'm thinking like kind of like the one good thing. I'm going to win a no prize here probably, but I'm thinking the one good thing that came out of Umbrella being like bastards. Is that, we left all these fucking, we took them all earlier, so we're not going to get them now. That sucks. I'm thinking like the one good thing that happened out of all this shit that went down is shit. Can they open doors? Nope, I guess not. Oh, it won't open. Just like that. Oh, God damn it. Fucking can't believe I did that. I do it every time. I hit triangle and then it goes away and then I hit the fucking right bumper. I'm just tired. Let's get some ammo in here. I was gonna make ammo and not use an herb and fuck that up. Yeah, I guess this game doesn't need to be tied to other games. It could probably stand on its own. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I don't want to talk too much about that because I'm sure we're going to be coming up to some kind of reveal at some point. Weird. Oh, shit. Oh, we gotta match him. Shit. Well, I didn't say so, you fucking game. Nice. Cool puzzle. We got all the corrosives. Nice. Okay, sweet. Now we can move around. It's only been connected. Not much. Yeah, it has. It does have some connections, but yeah, it hasn't been too much. Ow. This gun's pretty powerful. I'm gonna be honest. It's a little powerful, which I like. So this is where Evelyn started doing her vomiting trick. Holy shit. But yeah, there's been some, there's been a few ties, that's for sure. But I just they happened so many hours ago, and my mind is mush right now. So I'm sorry, I'm not as talkative as I usually am. I'm like running on fumes at the moment. Let's backtrack. I think there's a. In real life, the gun is actually the least powerful. Yeah, I was gonna say this one seems to be very effective, and it surprises me. Not just considering its size, but just in general. Like, I don't know, I wasn't expecting it to be like the other ones. Thanks, Santa. Oh shit, there we go. Lady Colt. Cool. Remote bomb. All right, captain's keys. Nice. What did we just pick up down there? Oh, nice. We're gonna go with health for now because I know I need more ammo, but we're just gonna. I'm hoping we get that machine gun. Plus, we got how many? We got two of these now, so, and we got the knife. So let's go back up to the. Let's go back up to the captain quarters and get that big fucking gun that he had. And I actually like that you get to play as Mia. Like, that's pretty neat. Because we've been Ethan the whole time, and we've never really seen Ethan's face yet. I mean, they're still hiding it from us. Mia, we've seen her face most of the game. So it's kind of cool to play as a character that I kind of know who she is and what's going on with her, you know? Whoa. Shit. So I was saying earlier, I think the one good thing that came out of this universe of biohazard weapons and stuff is the fact that there are healing items, you know, like, oh, bunch of monsters came out, but now you can, if you cut your arm, you can literally pour something on it, and it'll do something, you know, it'll heal it. Sweet. All right. That fast one makes me jump. I know, from Frankensee. Oof. Where are you, motherfucker? So can we actually go? It's showing on my map, like, but we can't move this, right? I don't know why we can. I'm sure Mia can lift that and push it over to the side. But it's on my map, it's saying it's a door you can walk through, kinda. Where's the crawler at? He's around here somewhere. Yeah, they got me as well. Yeah, those fucking, I call them the grasshoppers. They, those fuckers jump, man. They are no joke. Oh, yeah, we jumped through, we gotta go around. Shit, okay. Yeah, that's what I thought, right? The gas tank, good minds think alike, man. Yeah, I was wondering that myself. Wasn't there something up here we can use the corrosive stuff on, or was I tripping balls? There's a... Oh, it's locked from the other side, right? Ship first floor. All right, we can go to the first floor this way. And we can go to the fourth floor. Shit, didn't even think about that. Oh, this is the... Yep. Okay. So, all right. It's nice to close out map points where I'm like, I don't have to worry about... Like, what, you know, it's like, oh, good. We don't have to go that way. Fuck, people are crazy. It's an amalgamation of the turds you left behind on Sevastopol Station. Nice, Santa. Nice, dude. Nice. Yep, that's my cue to haul ass. Shit. Fuck. Damn, how many shots do you take? Nope, that's not what I want. Fuck. Fuck. That's not what I wanted. That's not what I wanted. I was trying to switch to the fucking bombs. God damn it. I'm like too tired to be dying because I don't want to redo much. And dead. Well, yeah, I mean, this is my first time playing this game, and it's a brand new game, and it's Resident Evil. So, yeah, it's like, I'm definitely going to be focused on this, like, more so than the chat, probably. And luckily, there's only, like, a small handful of people in here, so it's nice. Like, earlier when we were playing this, there was, like, 20-something people in here, and I was, like, trying to keep an eye on the chat, but I was missing so much. But I just like, I don't know. Like, I mean, it's Resident Evil, and normally my first playthrough on something like this is like, I almost didn't want to play it online my first time. I wanted to, I didn't want to do that, but I'm glad I did because I think it adds to the immersion too is, and it helps me out. Cause I fucking freak out. Shit. We don't have the fucking key. See, this is what I mean by dying. Like, we don't have the captain's quarters key, which where the fuck did we get that from? God damn it. Did we get it in here? I think we did. Nope. Did we not? We have the captain's key. Okay, so we just got to go back upstairs and use it. All right. All right, shit. Oh, you like it? Santa says, "Fuck the unimportant chunk of the people." Nah, I got you. Yeah, no, I mean, I feel you know me. Like, I like to keep up with chat the best I can, but I mean, it's Resident Evil. I'm kind of excited that I'm playing it. And they finally put the storage chest back. Yes, there's storage chests. save points. They use tape recorders though instead of ink ribbons and typewriters. But so you put a cassette tape in. That's pretty funny. All right, so we did all this. I think we can unlock this door now, right? Yep. And this will take us upstairs to the captain's quarters. I think we go up. No, we can't go up one more because it's the dead end. Sweet. I'm starting to learn this place now, finally. You're going to go sleep for a few? No problem, Angel. Everybody sent Angel some love. So here's the save. So, bam. And I may get a drink here in a second because I just noticed I'm really thirsty. All right, Echo's under the blankets, but if he wakes up, I may have to let him out in the yard to pee if he wakes up and needs to go to the bathroom. Oh, thank goodness. So we can make another one of those. Perfect. So the captain's quarters is up this way. Yes. Yeah, sleep tight, Angel. Oh, thank you, Santa. It's 20 after midnight here, also bedtime. If you got to get some sleep, Tony, no problem, man. I appreciate you hanging out with us as long as you did tonight. Fuck you. Hate those things. Not killing me this time, fuckface. 7:20 a.m. I have not slept. Yeah, I have not slept either. 4 p.m. over there, Santa? Yeah, I have not slept either. And I was up late the night before, too. If you guys didn't see my... Oh, there's some commands. I don't know if you guys saw them. If you hit Command Prize, P-R-I-Z-E, there is a gift for you. Command Prize, if you guys want something, and Command Resident Evil is something else that I stayed up late working on. Come in, dude. Son of a bitch. There you go. Neato. So yeah, there you go, guys. A free book. A crime novel that I wrote from me to you. All right, so now we have to go down to the first floor. Okay. Well, fuck. We're going to take the stairs on this end. And Resident Evil. So that is I basically, my first two streams ever here on Twitch were Resident Evil 1, or the remake. I played Chris Campaign and Joe Campaign. I spliced them together, made like a one single movie. Cut version of the game with audio commentary. I don't have any. Yeah, I don't have any yet. Oh, we can. Oh, snap. Shit. Let's climb down. Damn it, I missed that one. How the fuck did I miss that one? What? With commentary. Oh, I'll be watching this for sure. Yeah, it's pretty much the entire first game. Oof. Close that. But it cuts back and forth like a movie. So it shows like Jill and Chris, and it shows her solve a puzzle on one side of the mansion, and then it cuts to Chris on the other side of the mansion. It's pretty awesome. All right, so we read this by Giovanni Fanetti. We just got to go burn that door at the end of the hall here. Dear Janet, yeah, we read this one too. Okay. Yeah, and I cut it to about 3 hours, so it's one single video. I was going to put up like 4 half-hour videos or whatever, or 6 half-hour videos, but I was like, yeah, what's the point? Like, I spent all that time cutting it to be a movie with the audio commentary that I decided to roll with it, roll with the length. Well, that monster is pretty fucking dumb. Hey, a backpack. Machine gun ammo? Yes. So we're in the recreation room. And where else do we need to go that has the office? We need to go to the basement. Yeah. That's what she said. I'm late. What's up, Deadeye? You're right on time, brother. Corrosive, okay. So do we have any more corrosives that we had to do? Nothing here on this floor. The guest room. We didn't go to the guest room? On the second floor? Luckily, we're on the second floor. No, we're on the first floor now. All right. All right, let's go check out the guest room, I guess. Oh, in the control room, we need the on the third floor. Okay. Just making sure where we got to go. For work. Hey, you're back. All right. I love these bombs. The bombs are a nice touch. Mia's a badass, man. So she's the badass, and Ethan's the guy who just, he had no idea about her other life. That's pretty crazy. Yeah, nothing changed in here. Motherfucker. Shit. Seek, you have another gun. It's bigger and better. Shit. Be right back. No problem, Santa. Do your thing. All right, so not doing very good with health, though, with Mia. Unfortunately, that's because I keep getting my fucking ass kicked. We're going to take that herb. I mean, that herb, that fuse. And then there's a fuse on the third floor that we need to grab. Oh, yeah, here's the save room. Nice. We already raided this place, okay. Cool. So, all right. We need one more thingy thing. I think that's what they're called. I think they're called thingy things. Oh, it's our guest. This is our room. Corrosives. It's a save room too. Son of a bitch. Special Operative Division. Yeah, we read this earlier in the flashback. Where it told us that Mia is a special op member. We don't need to put anything away, right? We got everything here? Sweet. We're going to save, though. My Echo's still sleeping good. Third floor. Make it. Okay. Probably could have waited and saved up here in this room, but oh well. All right. We'll probably hit autosave after we burn through this door up here. Did we pick up a lockpick? We did not. Damn it. You would think after everything we've gone through, we would have found the fucking lockpick. Probably just has more ammo in it, but still. Those little ammo crates are nice. Come in handy. I'm going to move the camera a little close. Let's get a little close, guys. Is that the way it needs to turn? Yeah, there we go. Hey, that door's not gonna open, I guess. You sure? No, nothing? Not even a prompt? Okay. Ooh, oh, this is where we got thrown out into the ocean. Damn, Mia girl. Oh, I'm gonna fuck something up. I like this. There were stalls like this in Resident Evil Zero. That's pretty cool. I'm ready to blow shit up. Come on out, fuckface. Come on, dude. Come on, biscuit tits. Oh, shit. Took too many to kill him, but he got smart, dude. He threw up on it and blew it up. Yeah, fat boy coming. Yeah, that dude's gross. That dude is so fucking gross. I don't know what those are called, blobs or what. Oh, this is exactly what we need for the elevator. All right. Oh. Nice. It's kind of nice. How do we get back to the elevator, though? Oh, the elevator shaft's over that way? Okay, fuck. Nothing there. Nothing there. Oh, what's up? Chems. Nice. Let's make a... I don't know. What's our ammo situation? We have 12 handgun bullets. Oh, we can switch. Let's load that up. We can make 3 handgun bullets? That doesn't... Oh, times 10. Okay. So we can do that. And then we'll make this. All right. That's fair. It did. It only gave us 3 handgun bullets. What the fuck? I thought it said it was going to give us 10. Or no, it did give us 10. Oh, it did. Okay. I can't math right now. Okay. I'm back. Me as well. Kind of on and off. No problem. No problem. No problem. But yeah. We're good. Thank you guys for being here. All right. So the elevator shaft. So that's the door we couldn't go through. Fuck. Something's gonna come through here, isn't it? Come on, man. Let me... Oh. Okay, well, I was like, there's got to be some reason we came down here. I was like, there's nothing here. Shit, okay. Guess we're just going to head back the way we came. Nothing weird about that. Nothing scary or make me want to shit my pants about that. I knew something was going to come out of this bathroom and try to kill me. Shit. Yeah, this is crazy. So this is just left here? Like for 3 years? Like, does, like, the government just not know it's here? I mean, obviously it's not like a cruise liner, like, where innocent people were. So, like, you know, like, I can understand a little bit why there's, like, you know, like, maybe it just didn't fall off people's radar, but... Like no one found this in 3 years? That's crazy. All right, so where do we need to go to use this thing? Oh yeah, the actual elevator itself, which is right here. No, I didn't want to do that. Fucking game. Oh, shit. Now we want to go to S2. Get us the fuck out of here. Corporations paid the government off, I bet. I guess that's true. I mean, that's possible. But then how come the corporation didn't come and... look for them, you know? Like, if there is a corporation, why didn't they come and look for them? Like, who would... Because we were clearly... Mia was clearly transferring this little girl for somebody. Somebody big and important and possibly scary. So I'm kind of curious, like, where they are in all this. And why they didn't come looking for this boat. But, I mean, I get maybe a corporation, like you said, paying them off so no one, like... knew they were out in the water, maybe, and to some extent, or turn look the other way. But like I said, once it goes missing, I'm surprised even the corporation wouldn't feel like an invested interest in going to get them. We're gonna make we don't have an herb. Looks like I can make enhanced handgun bullets though. Let's do it. Shit. Shit, I'm glad I looked behind me. I honestly didn't hear that one. I was just like, la da 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 da. We killed one. Government conspiracy. There you go. Well, it's Resident Evil, so possibly. Well, maybe it could happen during RE6. No one could get there and the company was gone after that. Well, I mean, we're assuming it's Umbrella, which I don't want to assume that at all. But, because, I mean, Umbrella, for all intents and purposes, in this universe, is gone. And so is Neo Umbrella. So, as far as I know. So we'll get into that later after we beat the game and see what happens. All right, cool. We got more bombs. Nice. More great. Now I'm kind of wishing I didn't make handgun ammo because now they're just the game's giving me a shit ton of it. All right. I haven't seen any of those bobbleheads on this ship. I keep thinking someone must have one because this would be a good place to hide one, but damn, all that hand, I should have made more health. Damn. Oh, another bomb thing? God dang it. How many of these do we have? Like 8? Machine gun ammo? All right, that's nice. Oh, man. Gotta say, I like this level, though. Come get some, fuckface. I'm liking these bombs. The bombs are a nice touch. Shit. Oh, it's a puker. Come get some. We still got 3 left. What just exploded? Oh. We got so much fucking ammo right now. It's crazy. All right. So I like this now. So we came to save Mia, and now we're Mia going to save Ethan. This is awesome. This is like legit awesome. I'm glad we chose Zoe when we had the choice, because I feel like we're getting a very cool experience. Oh, right, an antique coin. Sweet. Only need 2 more of those. I guess, does that mean we're going to go back to the Baker's farm at some point? That'd be neat. Cargo bay and, yeah, so Ethan's in the engine room, I believe. So let's go over here and see what goodies we can find. Ah, look at that. Seek, you okay, bro? All night stream? Yeah, dude, I'm hurting. I'm hurting, man. But I appreciate you asking. I am hurting, though. And I'm waiting. My dog's under the blanket, so I'm waiting for him to wake up. Because when he does, that means he has to go to the bathroom. So I'll probably have to take a break and let him out. Oh, shit. Who's that? Oh, it's her. There's Ethan. Holy shit.
Ethan.
We found Ethan. Sup, Eatfeet? I think he drops dead any second.
Ethan?
Whoa. Whoa.
Son, neither is Marguerite, nor my boy Lucas, or even Zoe here. That girl Evelyn, she did this.
What the hell is she? Now, what did she do to you?
Fuck. He's normal.
She infected us with her gift. That's what she calls it. I found her near a busted out tank in the bayou. Everything changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No.
Whoa.
Not exactly, son.
He's so nice. Listen to him.
She forces her way into your mind, your soul.
Wow.
You can't fight back. You are connected to her, and you can't resist the urge to...
Shh. This is fucking awesome.
You're a different person after that. Just like Mia. So Mia sent me that message because of Evelyn.
Listen, the girl just wants a family of her own.
He sympathizes with her.
She's the key. All right? You find her. You stop her. Ethan. Free my family.
What the fuck?
Please.
Are we seeing this because we're in the like nest? Like, dude, they're victims? The fucking Bakers are victims? Like, I was kind of piecing that together, but seeing Jack Baker like that. And that's so interesting. Like,
silly, I told you, I'm not gonna hurt it.
He's like a religious guy, you know, he's family man, and he sympathizes with the little girl, even after all she's done. He's like, look, you have to stop her. It has to happen, but she just wants a family. Like, holy shit. Kill them all dead, I says. Dude, sometimes your enemy's not your enemy. Oh shit, Mia's losing it. Mia's losing it.
Mia, no. No.
Kill him. Shit, here we go. Equip your weapon, dude. We're just fucking just letting her. We're getting our ass kicked. Damn. Here we go again. Just like the beginning. Oh. I'm in the wreck ship the same as you. Yeah. What's up, Moons? Oh, you're here too? Nice, dude. The enemy that hurt you bad, well, that's when you decide what kind of person you are, I guess. Are you for the forgiving kind or not?
Why?
Shit. Fucking Mia's dead? Oh my god. Not 1 second hesitation. I have to dip out. You're way ahead of me. No problem, Moons. Yeah, get out of here, dude. So is Ethan infected too? Ethan, I don't think so. As far as I know, he's not. Because I think at the beginning when they were trying to feed him and stuff, you know, he kept resisting. And then also, Evelyn hasn't, like, talked to him. Like, she hasn't been in our heads as far as I know. But that sucks. That was a chance for us to see Ethan's face, and we didn't get to do it. I was hoping we would see that. So, do we have all the coins? Like, is all that just in our inventory box? Hopefully, it's all your fault. Fuck you! Oh, now we don't even have a weapon. Fuck it! I feel really naked right now. after running around with a submachine gun, now having nothing, I feel a little naked.
This open window can lead somewhere or nowhere. It's up to you. What do you mean, who is this? It's Chris. Why won't you believe me?